Hi guys, Muaz here, and welcome to this new tutorial on how to use and program in the Pic microcontrollers. We'll use in this tutorial MikroC Pro for Pic version 5 and the Proteus software ISIS professional to simulate our project. So today we will use the Pic 16F84A to blink a LED which is connected to a pin of this microcontroller. In our tutorial it will be the RB1 which is connected to our LED via a resistor. So let's start by making our program. Go to project, new project, next, give a name to your project, like blanking one for example. The directory, choose the Pic 16F84A, choose the clock, the device clock, 4 megahertz, next, and finish. So the MikroC environment will give you directly the void main function, which is the function of the main program, and you will find it in every, it must be in every program you develop. So there in MikroC you have two instructions you have to know by heart. The first one is the trace, and the second one is port. The first one you will add, for example, a trace B, which means to configure the port B as an input or output, or if we will use the port A, you will make the trace A. In our project we have our LED connected to the B port, so we'll make trace B and equal. So in MikroC, if you want to configure your pins as an output, you have to give the trace B register 0. If not, so you want to make it as an input, you have to give it the value 1. So let's give it the value 0, give it type B for binary, and I will type 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Why 8 numbers? So if you see here, you will find that the B port have 8 pins, RB0 to RB7, which means that they have 8 bins. So our LED is connected to the RB1 here, and we want to make it as an output. So we have made the mistake here. It must be the opposite. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So the 0 means, as I've told you, that the 0 means that our pin will be as an output and the others will be as an input. Here is the RB0, RB1, RB2, RB2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. The second one is the port B or the port A instruction. So in our story, we'll use the port B. If you give the port B, for example, I will give it in our simulation you can see that the LED is connected to port B1. So if I want to change the status of the LED, I should use the port B.F1. Why F1? F1 means that I will affect the value of the first pin here and not pin 0 or other pin, and I will give it the value, for example, 1. This means that our LED will be on. If I make port B point F1 equal 0, that will mean that our LED will be off. So in order to make our LED blinking all the time, I will need to make while 1, which means that our program will be executed in infinite time here. So you can see that our LED will at first be on, then off, but our program is executed fastly, so I will not see the changing statue. I will have to make a delay in the statue. I will use the instruction delay micro milliseconds, for example 500 milliseconds. So our LED will be on, then delayed and off, and I should add a delay here, 500 milliseconds. So as I've told you, our program will be executed infinite time. Our LED will be on, delayed, off, and then delay. So here is our program. We have finished. You have finished. Bravo. Now the last step is to build our project, to compile it. So in order to do that, click here and you can see that your project is built successfully, and here you can find the different information for the used RAM and used ROM, free RAM and free ROM. So now let's simulate our project by going to the ISIS Professional. Double click on your microcontroller. Let's set our clock to 4 MHz as we blinking. You have LED blinking. You have to choose the X file. And OK. Now let's go to and play. Here is the LED blinking, and it will do that in infinity time. So I hope it was useful for you. If you like it, subscribe to our channel. There will be more videos in the future. Good luck and bye.